have you ever felt?
Are you listening? Damn.
Yeah. Gotta wash them up. Gotta wash them up. Gotta wash them up real good. Oh, hey, everybody. Welcome back to Shinovka. Here on Farming Simulator 17. On Mr. Blue Farms. Just want to give a howdy big welcome. Hope all y'all doing okay. I'm doing fine myself. Thank you for asking. Just trying to clean up a little bit here. Yes, it is late. Just trying to get everything cleaned up. My harvest has been done. We got the planting done. I actually got all the weeding done. So it's just the cleanup time stage. Part that I hate. I'd much rather be out there on a combine thrashing. Come on, Mr. Clean Up. There we go. Sometimes, folks, you can get it about right there. And you can actually clean up both the weight and the tractor at the same time. Sometimes. Oh my God, look at these dirty trailers. Uh-oh, you're going off of there. Hose won't let me. Alright. All four of these should be loaded with soybeans. Ready for that demand. Or ready for that price to go up. Ready for this sinus to go away. Actually, starting to feel pretty bad, folks. But anyway, y'all don't want to hear that, right? I'm feeling this peachy. Lemon squeezy, right? Alright, we got all them done. Jump on over here. Got a pretty good size pile of wood chips there, but I wish they would let you, you know, some way of letting you know how much wood chips you got. I don't guess it tells you. I don't see it, don't tell you up there. Ooh, folks, we're going to have to get some sheep. Look at the price of that sheep. And all they do is eat grass. Something so simple. I see our soybeans right there, folks. For my peoples. $9.81 at the bakery. $9.74. Our village grain elevator went down on us. It was $1,000. I was stupid, should have took it. But yeah, that's part of life. Let's see here. Jump on over to this tractor here. We do have a few logs on the ground, so gotta get them up. Actually got several big logs on the ground. Hope it, since it's late, won't be no traffic. But yeah, we're gonna get these logs up. Oh man, I spoke too soon. Car coming. Hi, George. Hi. Car coming. Let's see here, pretty good length, so about right in here, maybe. Hang on a second for, cut this log in tow. Ah! Alrighty. Look at my muscles, man. Look at my muscles. I'm so strong. Oh, yeah. Flex those muscles. Oh, yeah. There we go. Yeah, turn our beacons on. Come on, hurry up. Let them away. Got work to do, folks. Working all... Whoa. Been working all day. All night. Let's see, what episode is it? This is our 16th episode, right? That man, 16 episodes. That's a Noka. I hope y'all happy. I'm happy. I love doing this for y'all. And I just want to say thank you. Thank you so much. And if y'all appreciate me doing this, y'all hit that like button, okay? That tells me you appreciate it too. Yeah, if you're new, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Whoa, folks. I'm going to use this one over here a little bit, then cut it. Probably going to put that small end in a wood chipper. Okay, that'll be about... Let's see here. Yeah, about right in here. Yeah, right here. It's been a very, very trustful, worthy Saul. He never gave me no trouble yet. Ooh, anyway. Wish my lights would stay on. I could do the manual ignition and it'll stay on, but that can get you in trouble, folks. If you forget to leave a tractor on, you come back, be out of fuel. Yeah. That's pretty neat, though. All right. We're starting to get another load there, folks. Don't know what all we're going to do in this video. I'd like to get these logs up here and then try to cut some grass tonight. I don't want to stay up too late, though, because, yeah. Need to go deer hunting in the morning, folks, you know. Shoot me a buck. Give me a buck and shoot it. Oh, I'm just going to be on my own side. I probably have to cut this again. How about seriously, old folks, I haven't been hunting this year. I gotta cut some of this off. Which, of course, I didn't go hunting last year either. Kind of miss it. I hate it when I hang up. Oh. Don't you do that to me. Oh, we got a glitcher. Oh, come on now. Go on in. Oh, yeah. You want to be that way? Huh? I'll take care of you. We'll do you like this. Stand back, folks. This thing may go flying or disappearing. That's what I hate about the tail end pieces. They want to act up and stuff. Don't fall out, little guy. Just stay in there. You're fixing to be doing good. Just a little bit more. This guy here is good, this wood chipper, but only complaint I got on him is he needs to be longer. Oh wait, that's what she said. Go ahead, take her away. Is our system still working? No, our system ain't working, folks. Ah, that's why. Unload here. It should unload. There it goes. There it goes. Up, up, up. No matter. Where'd I go? Where'd my stuff? Oh. Exit out on the wrong side. Ah! I go over here, we all can see. Y'all see that? And unload here. Don't think about it, folks. You gotta do that every time you come back to Sinopka. Here we go. See? Big old pile of weeping wood chips. Yeah. That's what I was going to say. Wood chips. But speaking of poop, we're going to have to get us one of those solid manure spreaders and get us a liquid manure spreader. Yeah. So we can start swinging some poop around. Don't have a poop fight? Oh my god, it's just nasty, ain't it? I'm sorry I brought it up. My bad. Wow! Whoa! Okie dokie. This tree just punched me in the face, seems like. Alright, we're going to do something different here this time. We need more wood chips. Of course, selling logs get us more money, but we have a demand for wood chips. We might make more money. I don't know. Can't really take it into consideration or anything like that. Back on up all over wood chips here. Wow! Alright, we're going to pick up that rat in here. Yep, that rat in here, we're going to pick it up. And, get under it here. Back up, get straight. We're going to just pick up to all the weights on that end down there. We almost had it. And I ain't back up far enough yet. Let this baby back down. Gotta get over some more, folks. Oh yeah, we gotta get way on over. You gotta have all the weight on the conveyor, pretty much. That should do it. There you go, folks. See there? It's starting to go in now. And you should see wood chips falling back behind me there. Come on. There we go. Oh, that's a pretty sight right there. I need to be grinding up faster. Come on. Faster than this, folks. My peoples, this is how we wood chip on Mr. Blue Farms. We're just going to kind of force it down her throat here. What? Uh-oh. Yeah, we're getting a pretty good pile of wood chips behind the wood chipper. All that really does, folks, with the conveyor belt is, conveyor started to move. But, all it does, it keeps this pile from getting big. And, yeah. Okay. See, the time it gets. See, that don't get very tall right there, so I got that maxed up to as tall as it'll get, and just think of how big of a pile of wood chips we can get right there. I like to have big wood chips. Okay, I don't know where that come from. I have no idea. Looks like we got one long one left here, folks. Alright, yeah, we got one long one left. Yeah, see, I need to be on the other side. Need to be on this other side so it come out right. Well, we got, we got a bouncer. We got a bouncer in the house, folks. What makes them bounce, folks? They're in the ground at the back end back there. It's this glitch on the computer part. Ain't nothing that we done to it. Now I'm cutting it down. It's not, it's not mad because we cut it down. Nope, don't think about that. Nah, get away from the concrete. There we go. Into the wood chipper you go. I like to get it as close as possible. Well, not that close. There we go. And open my mouth up. Insert foot. Oh, wait. Different situation, folks. Different situation. See, I don't want to get too close because then it'll fall before it gets to where I need it. Just gotta judge it, folks, to what you think is right. You know, I can't hold your hand all the time. Unless you just raise it all the way up and she'll start sliding. That's what we like, folks, when she starts sliding. There goes our wood chips over there. Let's see here. Get that window off there so y'all can see better. May have to move our trailer. It's going to get wood chips piled up around it. No, we're going to be in trouble. Oh, stay on there. There we go. Oh, horses for two, folks. Just think when we have about four or five people working at another wood chipper on the other side. Well, back behind this and bringing another pile in. Whoa. There we go. Yeah, there we go. Shine a little bit more light on the area. Holy cow, folks. 842 loan interest. 7,190 vehicle learning costs. 400 animal upkeep. Hey, we got $60 income. Where we get income from? Property income. Oh, I bet it's a little robot helper. The only thing I can think of, folks. Why is our conveyor stopped? Sometime, folks. You can detach that and it works a whole lot better. Well, let's see here. Oh man, really? That, how's it going to go? Anyway. I'm going to move the tractor out of the way. Maybe that's what's causing it. It is a pretty close spot. We do need to move this trailer up here, get it out of the way, grind these stumps up real quick. Now we're going to put this tractor and hook him to the loader wagon. Let's see here. Should be out of the way right there. Gonna leave him parked there. Trying to think, folks. Should be two more stumps out there somewhere. Make sure there ain't a little piece of whoops up there. Let's see. Okay, this is the third one. Whoa. Alright, should be one more stump. Uh oh. Where's the other stump at, folks? Yeah, drive over it. Ah, right here it is. I was getting scared there for a minute. Okay, I'm kind of getting a little mad. I'm expecting this to get bigger. I was wanting to be bigger. Come on, let me see what chips out. I don't want to get that pile as big as that right there. Folks, I could hire a worker. Yeah, right there. I don't have my help. I don't know what to do. Oh, yeah. Let me turn my help on for a minute. Folks, remember our little robot friend? It had changed the angle. Okay? Well, see, right here on the Y, you got 5, 10, 15, 20, up to 50, then it goes back to 5. Alright, you hire a worker. That's what you're going to do, right there, right there. Okay? But if you change that angle, he's going to go a whole lot further over. All he does is go back and forth. This is good when you're doing like sugar beets or something. You got a lot of them to dump and pile in a shed. You would want to measure your shed out and just let it go back and forth like this. And, yeah, see? It just makes your pile come over more. It kind of keeps your pile level, folks, see? It's building up on over. I guess that's the tall maximum I'll be. Woo! Dang, that was stupid. I got wood chips in my mouth now. Let's see here. I'm going to go ahead and detach this. Let's see. I'm just going to put them right here. Wow! No! What happened? Folks, also, you want to make sure when you undo this guy, bring him over to the center of your tractor and raise him up a little bit. Not too much, just about right there. And you lower him down to the ground, then detach him. And it kind of falls back in place. But we got this hire, this worker, let's see, all the wood chips up. A little bit right there, so we'll let that be right now. We just got to stop this guy. All All right. We're going to say that's enough of horseshoe right now, okay? I'm going to leave the plow there. I need to work on this corner here. I'm thinking about just bringing it over a little bit further. Trying to come out here just a little bit more and bring it down like that. So it'll be just a little bit more straight so you won't leave nothing on the ends. But I do have it set to one time on my time scale because I don't want crops to grow as fast right now. Because I need to do some other stuff. Whoop. There's our loader wagon. Back up. Let's see it. Pretty good size loader wagon. You know, we could have the big one, but I just don't think we need it right now. Let's check our cows real quick, folks. Oh, are beans going up yet? No, still about the same. I know they won't go up too fast because we're on one time. We still got that bank loan payoff, folks. Really got to get it paid off. Alright, we ain't got no pigs. I don't have to worry about that. We need to do something about getting some sheep next, folks. Let's say the cow's going to need some grass. That's one reason why we're cutting. A little bit of water. And power food's going to be okay for right now. Until we get to forklift tractor back over here. So, having said all that, we're going to go cut some grass, okay? Where are we going to cut grass? Well, we're going to cut it pretty close because we don't want to travel too far. We need to fill this silo right there back up. Wow! We're going to go over here and start back here, folks. Alright, let's turn this guy on. Turn our mower on. We should be good to go. Should be good to go. Yeah, I know this is kind of a long, boring process, but it's part of the game, folks. Need to find me a good flat spot. Actually, you know what? I always like to shut my mower off when I'm crossing the road or turning. Let's mow our sides, folks. Right in here. Since we own these fields now. Alright, you pretty much see what all it is to it here. You just drive around collecting grass. Yep, that's pretty much all it is to it, folks. But I'm going to be right back, okay? When I get a full load, I'll show y'all how to dump it and stuff. So I'll be right back. Alright, folks, we got a full load and we're back here at the farm. We can show y'all a little trick to keep it even. First thing you want to do is down your cruise speed to about 3. Go ahead and apply it. And look at all that dust in that light. But you just want to get in here like this right here. Kind of zoom out so you can see. As soon as your back latch gets across, let me redo that. Sorry, folks, I was on the wrong tool there. Just get going in here like this. Make sure you're on the right tool. Maybe on the back tool. As soon as you pass the marker there, start unloading your trailer. Make sure you don't hit the wall. Look how even that makes it, folks. See? And you just do the same thing each time. Like, next time you come in, you want to get over to your other side there. Or you can just keep coming down through here, but when you start your next load, start it where that ends. Okie dokie. Alright, let's see here. We need to find another grassy area. Let's start right here. We're going to lower a thing on. Turn it on. Turn me on, baby. You turn me on. Put that down. Oh. I'm just going to put our cruise speed back up to max, which we only go 12 miles an hour anyway, so. And that's pretty much it, folks. That's how you do it. Done a couple rounds over there, and then I went to the far side over there, done a couple rounds. And I got looking at my fuel gauge. I'm going to get some fuel for this tractor pretty soon. We might need to fill them all up before the next harvest. Or at least fill the ones up that we're going to keep. You know, the reason I say it like that, you know, like that old tractor. And I say old. One thing I hate about going to the menu when you're in this stage, or stage, it will shut your tractor completely down. We need to get us a grass field. Whoa, that's rough. Yeah, we need another field just for grass. That way we get that bunker filled up. If we get sheep, they're going to be wanting lots of grass, folks. And speaking of sheep, I guess we'll go ahead that way. Dump a load in that and pick up grass on our way back from the sheep to the cows and just keep going back and forth till we get everybody full. Folks, I don't like to mow when I'm turning, because it could leave some grass on the ground if I turn too sharp. And if you get too much grass on the ground, I don't know about 17, but back in 15, it could cause a lot of problems. That would make you glitch out a lot. Uh-oh. Raise more up. Shut that off so I can go faster. And show y'all some of this over here. Which I ain't been over here on 17, but feel like a broken record. Talking about 15 all the time. So you switch back to my mower. See, we got a lot of ground right here that's not ours, but, you know, I talked to the other farmer that owns this. He said, mow it all you want, be less for him to mow. So, yeah. But you kind of want to stay away from the highway part of it. Further you get towards the field, better. But that, folks, I don't know if that's a selling point or an actual spot to put silage there or grass. Cause see, well, it does label a selling point, don't it? Or does it? What does our? Yeah, see, we don't have one up by the cows. That's got that symbol, so that should be a selling point for grass. But yeah, that's the sheep area right there. Or at least it's supposed to be. I don't know how much sheep is, but ain't no telling. I think they're like 3,000. I know the pigs are 3,000. Yeah, you just see, you got all that down through there. So if we had a bigger mower, you know, the back attachment, we could come over here, do like a bunch of mowing, then come back with a windrower or something, windrow it up. That'd be faster than this, you know. Still got to do a lot of work, do it, but I think it'd be worth it, folks, you know. Now, I'm kind of curious. Let's shut everything off and go on over here to the feeding trough. I like to get into some sheep here pretty soon, folks. We'll have to do a mission or two. Let's see what it says here. As soon as you purchase some sheep, they will start producing wool over time, and pallet with several stacks of wool will appear here. You can pick it up with a front loader and transport it to a spinnery where you can sell it. And that stuff is high too, folks. I wonder if it's anything like Goldcrest, where they, you know, they have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 by 6 pallets right there. This should be where we put the grass. And that in there should be where we dump the water. Yep, yep. Oh, oh, oh. Wow. Of course, that will add more capacity to that when there's just 2,715 liters right now. More sheep you get, the bigger, or a lot more you can put in there. So we need to bring our water trailer up here, fill up the water trough, and then get one of those robot buddies up here. And yeah. Alright. Oh, I forgot. We got to feed our cows some grass. So we better get back busy. Let's see here, folks. What was that? Oh, yeah. Turn this back on. Turn more on. Set our cruise. And back to the cows we go. Yeah. So it's okay to turn a little bit like this, because it's not going to leave no grass with that much. You can turn a little bit sharper too, but yeah. Alright, folks, I guess I'm going to be right back. I'll meet you back at the cows, okay? Alright, folks, we are back here at the farm. That dude would have to be in the way. Let's go down here to the little robot and see if we can dump it down there. I'd be afraid I'd get hung up right there. As y'all can see down here, we got plenty of straw. Our little buddy's still doing pretty good. He's getting off track some. That it? That was it, folks. Alright, we're going to get out of his way. I'm going to put the rest of this in a silo bunker. Alright, once again, now if you just go through, I should be starting on the other end. I think I will go down there and start. Go ahead and get my cruise set back to 3. Whatever cruise speed you use, make sure you use it the second time, folks. Use it the every time. Because if you don't, it's going to make a different thickness. Okay, you just come in here like this. It's going to be a little rough, but nothing like it will if you just stop and dump. So I got the same cruise. You don't want to dump yet. You just want to wait till your trailer gets right about the back end. And now, oh crap, I did it again, folks. Sorry about that. I had my selection on the front tool. See, just want to start dumping there. That makes a little pile, but it starts spreading out pretty good. There you go. Let's see. Let me get out and show you a little bit better. But look at it. It just stays pretty well even. You don't have a little high spot there, but that's nothing compared with it. Imagine a lot of these. You know, every time you stop, you have a big old pile trying to fill it up. But look at this. You see how a majority of it stays pretty straight. Once you get this run out, come back, start right here, and go right down through here. You know, and then you'll come back right here, you start your next one here, go on down. It'll end about right here. You'll probably get about maybe 2 more loads that way. So that's 2 loads right there, folks. So you come to here on this side here, it'll be 4 loads, so 8 loads will just get you to that fill level. So you imagine 8, 16, what, 32, and gone. So yeah. All right, get our flashers on, beacon lights here. I don't know why I call them flashers. Let's see. We got our cows fed. We got another little load in there. I'm trying to think of another good spot we can hit. That's close. Let's go. Well, pigs don't use. I guess we'll go back down through this way, folks. Turn our loader wagon on. Switch to the front. Turn our mower on. Set our cruise, folks. Whoa. Yeah. Turn your cruise up before you go engage it, folks. That's a quick stop. No. But, yeah, you want a better place than this. We really need a flat spot, but I don't want to get too close to that river there. One of those trees might get mad at me and push me off over in it. But yeah, folks, is there anything like this y'all want to see? Any particular ground you want me to buy next or anything like that? Just shoot me a comment down below. I want to. Mr. Blue wants to grow his farm with y'all. So whatever y'all want, I'll try to be reasonable. Now, y'all want to see a different loader wagon? We'll try to save up and shoot for it next. And just stuff like that, folks. I want to thank y'all. wasn't for y'all, wouldn't be getting the support I'm getting. I do want y'all to do me a favor. Share me, folks. Share me with your friends, family. I need to get my community a little bit bigger. I want to have more of your friends out there so I can show more people. And I'm trying to shoot for 50 subscribers by the end of the month. I'm up to 22. And I'm so thankful for y'all for coming and joining my channel. But being part of my community, you know, we got to do a few things together there. I'm going to try my best to, I just got myself in a pickle. Oh, there's a wall there. Whoa. Oh, my goodness. Yeah, I'm going to try to do more things like this to get y'all entertained and stuff, you know. Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness, folks. Oh, no. No, no, no. Don't turn over. Oh, that was lucky. Let's go under the bridge here. Under the bridge. Under the catwalk. Hey, how many of y'all out there is Red Hot Chili Pepper fans, huh? Red Hot Chili Pepper fan, hit that like button and put a comment down below, folks. I don't like all their songs. I probably just lost a bunch of subscribers for saying that. But that one, Under the Bridge, and there's a couple others. I used to listen to that when I was younger. Van Halen, Aerosmith, Def Leppard. Def Leppard is my number one, folks. I can't remember. Whoa, rough there. I can't remember what age I was, but, you know, I was old enough. I was working. I was working on a farm, believe it or not. Matter of fact, I was working for Fred Austin, if any of y'all around Blytheville, Luxor, Osceola area. Y'all know old Fred. He's still good and good. Still doing what he does the best. But I used to work for his son, Vance. Well, I worked for Fred, too, in Hardy Sales and Service. But, I worked on the... Went working on the farm first out there for Vance. And then I got a spider bite on my arm. Of all places, under my armpit almost. And I got a chance to work up at Hardy Sales because, you know, doctor told me to keep it clean because it's real bad infected. I thought it was a daggum, what you call them, pimple, is it? And didn't think nothing about it, you know. It was one Sunday morning sitting around at the kitchen table. Of all places. Kind of felt something crawling or something, so I went to scratch it, went to kind of like just grab my shirt and, you know, squeeze it till I get a chance to see what it was, and boy, I done something stupid. I guess when I squeezed it, he bit me or something. And the next day or two, I'm like, hey, damn, I got a big old pimple popped up there, you know? All right, we're back on our ground now. But anyway, to make it short, the spider bit me. It was a brown macruse. Boy, let me tell you something. Pimple wasn't nothing compared to what was, you know, I just wasn't even paying attention to it. Just thought it was a zit. And I went to work a couple days there and working on a cotton picker. And I just got through driving that cotton picker. You know, it was the first time driving it on his farm, on Vance's. And, we got all greased up. There was a lot going on there. You know, our foreman left. And then I became foreman. And so he asked me if I could drive a picker. I said, I've been on them, but I never drove them. I know how to operate them and how to check the water and all that stuff. So he told me to get on it, go to town. So, well, not actually go to town, but, you know, go to work. So we jumped in the first field there, and I got on my phone, and I don't know, was it YouTube back then, I guess? I think it was. Anyway, I done something on my phone, looked at it, what settings was supposed to be and stuff. And called up one of my friends and told him what picker I was on and what the water pressure should be for spindles and all that stuff. And sure enough, I got started. Started picking, drove it for about 3 or 4 days, didn't have no problem. That daggum bump on my arm got so big and deep. It was eating a hole out about the size of a number two pencil there. But, yeah. But anyway, they put me, you know, I went to a doctor. Told me I had to keep it clean or I was going to be in trouble. So I kept it clean. Told Fred, and he's like, well, do you want to work? I'm like, well, yeah, I need money, you know. And at the time, I was married to my first wife. And so, you know, I had rent and bills and all that to pay, and party hardy and all that good stuff. And so I went to work for Hardy Sales for about a week. Got to stop mowing. We're full. When I come back and pick that up. See, that didn't take too long. But, what was it? God, I need a new controller. My down button don't want to work half time. Oh, there we go. About 3 mile an hour. But anyway, on the story there, I was at Hardy Sales for about a week or so, and Fred's other son, Jason, came in, got me, and said, you know, I drive a combine. And I, well, same story, you know, with the cotton picker. Oh, crap. Can't talk and do two things at once, can I? All right, here we go. Should be set this time. Unload. Perfect. See how that lined up, folks? There you go. A little short that time, but yeah, you just do that to the next one there. And then I think you can get 4 right in here, this empty area. But anyway, we got about 5 minutes left, maybe, if I figure my math right. Let's see, folks. Let's do something a little different here. Y'all probably tired of that, but I'm going to finish my story while we're doing it different. We're going to pull up here and fill these bad boys up and see what kind of debt we can go into. Combines. Okay, I'm going to reset him. But anyway, yeah, Jason came and got me, and Jason Austin, that is, and wanted me to drive a combine. And I said, well, you know, like I told your dad, I've been on combines before with my uncles and stuff, but my dad, but I've never drove one by myself. You know, I've always been up there in the cab driving one, but I know what to do. Just might have to set things up for me. It said the combine's already set. I've been out there cutting myself, so let's get on and go to work. So he took me to way back in the boondocks across the levee there, between Luxor and O'Donnell Bend. It's actually a Scott Stanford ground, if y'all are familiar with the area. Let's see. He needs some fuel. Take him up to shop, fill him up. We're going to bring all the tractors and stuff in, take a look at them, do some maintenance and stuff while we're waiting on the crops to grow. But, yeah, so that's how I got started driving a combine, folks. That was an 8820 Titan II John Deere combine. There's two of them. One had a green top, other had a yellow top. I got stuck with the yellow top. I'm like, man, can I do no, drive at him. So I'm kind of glad I did. The one he got on was the, you know, green top, and I got in the yellow top one. He didn't even make a round, and the belt broke. So he told me to go to Hardy Sales, get a belt, start a John Deere place, I mean. So went up there. Got the belt and everything, came back, he said, well, put it on. I'm like, okay. And, you know, here I was, didn't have the tools I need or anything. So, finally managed to get it all put on. And, let's see. Got back, I got it working, got on it, he's like, switch with me. So, yeah, I switched with him, and, you know, we all got it back going, and, well, I got it back going and stuff, we switched, and then, he made like maybe two rounds, it wasn't even 10, 15 minutes, and something else broke. All right, there you go, Jason. He's getting furious. And, I ain't got enough fuel there. So, I can't remember what broke. But, end up getting it fixed and everything. I said, you ready to swap out? He said, no, stay on it. I was like, you sure? I'm like, yeah, stay on it. That way, if something else breaks, you can drive it. I mean, get it fixed. So, I stayed on that mug the rest of the season, folks. Ooh, this needs... Oh, my God. I said I wasn't going to fill them all up. Let's check this, folks. But, yeah, I stayed on that green top one for the rest of that harvest season. We cut all Scott Stanford's ground. Hopper's Exxon and a bunch of other people's we done custom harvest for. Alright folks, that pretty much ends up that story. The Zetro 150. Now this was what I want to check. Yeah, see our price right there? Trying to look. Zetro. Is that the one we got? Just taking a fast look here, folks. I guess this Zetro HD. That's only the Zetro we got, so it's got to be that. Go to the garage here. Go to the garage. Is that it? Hours, 14 days. 14 days. The lizard R500. It's down to $5. Well, folks, we only got two things. It's 14 days. Forterra. The Zetro Forterra HD. See, it's in the red. We don't want nothing that's in the red because that's going to give us higher maintenance costs. So, go back to our thing here. So, yeah, 14 days. Well, let's forget it's 14 days. Ooh, 15 days on a planter. We ain't getting rid of our planter, though. It's got 21 hours on it. 13.5. And 0 day. Man, I lost track of the days. Oh, yeah, there we go. 12 days, 4 days. Ah, the roller packer. Is that $5.76 a day? I hope so. 4 days. Oh, that's 14 days, but it don't show no maintenance on here, so. $146.04 a day. All right, that's what's giving us money, folks. $5 an hour. So that's what's making us money. All right, let's see here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 tractors, 2 combines. Yep, that's all we got, folks. So we need to get ready to replace that Zetro with a newer tractor. What's the biggest tractor we got right now? Case? Oh. The Series 9. And I like to get a bigger tractor, but I don't know if we can afford it right now because we got to pay the bank loan back. Now this for Series 9. Who yet? It's 7. That's 9. That's what we got right there, folks. I might go a little bit bigger tractor than him. And here's the next one up would be the Massey Ferguson. Let's see. 295, 300. 37 mile an hour. 31 mile an hour. I might go with that, folks. The T8. Or the Fendt 900. Vitro S series. S7's the Challengers and stuff. I don't want to go that big right at this moment. Let's check out this guy. Pretty much a color and rim color standard. Wheel weights, wide tires. Ooh, twin wheels. 319,000. Whoa. Okay, let's go on over to the last tractors here. Okay, he's only 210. Folks, I don't get it. The Fent here, Black Beauty. That's 900 Vibro. It's same as this guy. 300 horsepower. 300 horsepower. That. And then wheel weights, wide tires, twin wheels. 341,000 hopes. I might get that tractor next. I really do. Replace it with the one that's old. But anyway, folks, that's probably our next couple of series here. Is just working up, getting some money for this guy here. Get him replaced. I guess until next time, I might do a little bit more mowing and stuff off the hand. Let's get in here and let this guy down a little bit. Let's park him on over a little bit so we can wash him. But I might do a little bit more mowing off screen, try to get those that thing there filled up a little bit more. Yeah, that's about it for right now, folks. We're pretty much out of time. I kind of figured about 20 minutes, and here we are at 28 minutes. And we also got to compact this stuff, see? 14% compacted. So to compact it, you just drive back and forth over it. But, folks, let me tell you something. Each time you dump, you might want to drive across it then, because if you get this thing full and then go try to compact it, it's going to take you forever. Yeah, so try to keep it like 80, 90% compacted each time you dump. Because, if you know, 26 here, you're going to really, really be driving a lot across it. See, you just have to be on the chaff part of it to compact it. Driving this area here ain't going to do it. You have to actually drive here. But anyway, yeah, I might make another load or two. Kind of make a finish this heap out here, get it compacted, and get it tarped. And that should be enough to take care of the cows a couple more seasons or whatever. But anyway, folks, this has been Farming Simulator 17 at Shinofka. You're all Mr. Blue Farms, and I appreciate you coming out, hanging with me today. So if you enjoyed it, make sure you hit that like button, subscribe to my channel if you ain't done it yet, share me with your friends, and folks, please, wherever you at, have a blessed day, night, whatever it is to you. And we'll see y'all next time, okay? Mr. Blue, signing off. Bye.